May the 26th, Mark chapter 14 and Proverbs 26. Have you found some great nuggets for us to share together today? Boy, Mark chapter 14 is a long chapter, isn't it? 72 verses. Well, let's share nuggets and get rich together. For me, in Mark chapter 14, my nugget came out of the early part of the chapter. I'm going to go ahead and read to you verses 12 through 16. It says, on the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, where it was customary to sacrifice the Passover lamb, Jesus said to his disciples, where do you want us to go and make preparations to eat the Passover? Now that's verse 12. I want to back up just a minute and read verses 10 and 11 before this, which says, then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, went to the chief priest to betray Jesus. They were delighted to hear this and promised to give him money. So he, Judas, watched for an opportunity to hand him over. So Judas is watching for an opportunity to hand Jesus over. So the very next verse, the disciples say to Jesus, where do you want us to have the Passover? And Judas is sitting there watching, going, okay, yeah, tell me where the Passover will be, and I'll go tell, and we'll get you arrested during the Passover. And Jesus knew all this. God had given him wisdom and insight and word of knowledge. And so Jesus did not want his Passover interrupted. And so that's why in verse 13, so he sent two of his disciples to go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you, follow him, then say to the owner of the house, the teacher asks, where's my guest room? So basically, Judas is standing there going, huh? They're supposed to go just walk in and wait till they just bump into some guy who's carrying a jar of water, which men never carry jars of water, so that guy would really stand out. Then they follow the guy and say, the teacher wants to know where his room is. And so Judas is like, what's all these clues? And how am I supposed to ever figure out how the room is? So the end result was, until they walked into the Passover room, Judas didn't know where it was. Only the two disciples who set it up. And Jesus knew where it was. And Jesus did that intentionally because he knew that Judas was looking to arrest him. And it wasn't until Jesus dismissed Judas from Passover, and then Judas later caught up with him in the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus was determined. And so it's kind of just sly and cool and strategic and wise and intriguing how Jesus used such brilliance and strategy and word of knowledge to make sure things happened at the right time. Just love the insight there on that. Now let's go ahead and go over to Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 26, verse 8 is a verse that is another verse that grew for me after the first couple decades. First couple decades, I didn't really get it. The verse says, like tying a stone in a sling is a giving of honor to a fool. Now, you know about a sling, it was a strap, and you put the, basically a strap of leather with a piece here, then another strap of leather, you hold it, and then you'd swing, you'd let go of one end, and then the stone would fling out. And so if you did the stone in the sling, and you would swing, and then you would throw it, and if the stone was stuck in the sling, the harder you threw, the more it would jerk your arm. And I wrote down these words. The harder you try to help them, the more you get hurt. Now who's them? Them are fools. One of the most dominant teaching about Proverbs is don't try to help people who don't want to change. You only help people who want to change. People who want to change will humble themselves. People who want to change will take ownership of their attitudes. People who want to change will do homework. If people are not willing to humble themselves and do homework and take ownership of their attitudes, then don't try to help them. And so if you say, oh, they didn't understand, feel sorry for them, give them honor. The more you try to help people who don't really want to change, the harder you try to help them, the more you're going to hurt yourself. Whew. Took me a long time to figure out some of this stuff. And nice part is you're never too old to learn a little more. Hope you're having a great day, whether you're young or old. Hope you're still young in heart. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.